Their water syringe has many uses. Ways that it should never be used is without a test spray first. So usually I'll either spray it on my pant leg or just a little bit on my arm like that. And it should never be used on a patient without giving a warning to your patient. So I'll usually say something like, I'm going to spray a little bit of air first, and then I'll slowly spray that air in their mouth. And you never want to do a blast spray, which looks like that. That's crazy rude. So what you want to do instead is start, usually I'll point it away and I'll start a little bit of the airflow, and then I'll bring it into the area and spray that air nice and slowly. The air alone is used in detecting supragingival calculus. When doing this, you want to give a slow and steady stream of air on a particular area, and I like to use this the most, of course, on these linguals of the mandible. Nice and slow and steady, and you have to actually use quite a bit of air on a particular surface to be able to see the calculus magically disappear. As you can see, some of that calculus now as I've used a lot of that air. When you're doing periodontal debridement, and if you want to see down in a pocket, you just use the air directly down into the pocket, point it right towards the sulcus. And of course, candy has really healthy gums, but the pocket will actually deflect open and you can see down into the base of the pocket. The water alone can be used to rinse the patient. If the patient is sensitive to cold water, I'll usually fill up the back of the mouth with water so they can warm it in their mouth, and then I'll have them swish, and then when they're ready, they can close their lips around the straw. To rinse the patient, I'll usually hold the water about 3 to 5 millimeters away from the tooth itself at about a 45 degree angle. And keep it close to the tooth so that it doesn't spray out of the mouth. I just kind of run it along all the teeth so it doesn't deflect in the wrong direction. And close your lips on that. If you ever have an area that's being stubborn and the debris is not coming off like you want, you can actually use the air and the water button at the same time. So usually I'll start with a little bit of water, and then I'll add the air in. There we go. And that will help to blast away any of that debris that's not coming off with just a regular rinse. And you can do big circular motions, or kind of a back and forth motion like that.